Good evening. The drawn-out rally between the federal government and Novak Djokovic continues. The immigration minister is yet to make his decision on whether he'll cancel his visa. The world number one's been named in the Australian Open draw on another day of drama at Melbourne Park. Adam Hegarty has the latest.
Novak Djokovic practising on centre court and taking centre stage in the Australian Open. Soap opera. The reigning champion feeling the heat in more ways than one, but despite the threat of deportation, he manages a smile, preparing as normal with a visa cancellation at this stage. Still nothing more than a threat.
I refer to Minister Hawke's most recent statement, and that position hasn't changed, and these are personal ministerial powers able to be exercised by Minister Hawke, and I don't propose to make any further comment at this time.
That doesn't mean they didn't spook open organisers.
Have you heard anything from the government?
Yeah, no, I'm not going to make a comment at this point.
Have you heard from Novak's camp yet?
We'll let you know.
The official draw, slated for 3 p.m, abruptly postponed, but then at 4:30, the inevitable. On paper, he plays.
We start with our number one seed for the tournament, Novak Djokovic.
The world number one, or public enemy number one. The world's divided.
Rafa could not have put it any better. Just get vaccinated.
The Serbian top seed facing accusations of several international offences, entering Australia with a false declaration, like travelling to Spain, where officials are also investigating him, and in Serbia, breaking isolation rules.
I think that the rules that one person follows is the rules that everybody should follow. He's still a child of God like the rest of us, isn't he? So he's got to abide by the laws.
Immigration Minister Alex Hawke with his finger on the deportation trigger, sifting through more documents from Novak's lawyers, the federal government's legal minds getting their ducks in a row. They won't face Novak on court, but they don't want another embarrassing defeat in court.
I'm very confident in the actions that Minister Hawke will go through in order to consider this matter properly.
Well, Adam, could there be a decision tonight?
No. There won't be, Pete, but look, that's not to say the immigration minister won't still go through with cancelling Novak's visa and trying to deport him in the coming days, potentially tomorrow. But as a source in the federal government put it to me a little bit earlier, he's just trying to be extra, extra careful in this instance, considering what's happened in the past couple of days and over the past week. But that poses a couple of real dilemmas and issues, particularly for the Australian Open, for instance. The longer this drags out, the more it wreaks havoc on the actual tennis and the draw. And Pete, then there's the question on how on earth do you detain the world number one Novak Djokovic when he's already out in the city?
Adam Hegarty with the latest. Crowd numbers at the Australian Open will be slashed by half over fears of the tournament becoming a super spreader event. Maggie Rayworth's at Melbourne Park. Maggie, how many will be allowed to attend?
Well, Pete, in what is another blow for the Australian Open, the state government has announced a new COVID-safe plan which will impact ticket sales. Under the new rules, crowds will be cut back by 50%. Now, the state government says this won't impact those who have already purchased a ticket. Those tickets will still be valid and they can still go. The new measure will impact those who haven't yet bought their ticket. Now, some people are disappointed. They say many people go to the tennis for that atmosphere. Others say they do feel more safe with these measures in place.
I mean, it's a good result for me as someone who has a ticket already. Less lines for the get a beer, or you know, less competition for seats. But you know, obviously, I think it's the best thing in terms of safety at the moment.
Pete, there will be density limits under the new rules for all indoor settings inside the tennis, and for anyone who attends, they will be required to wear a mask at all times, except, of course, if they're eating or drinking. But these rules kick off when the Australian Open does on Monday, Pete.
OK, Maggie, thank you.